We are here with Pias and Jayshree from Seed. So welcome, guys. Why don't you introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about your ministry and where you work.
Hi, I'm Pastor Pias. I'm from Seed Entrust Equip Disciple Society. In short, you can call Seed Society. I'm from India.
Hi, I'm Jayshree. I am the director of Seed. Especially look after the child development and women care portion. And I am from India, Kolkata.
Would you mind giving us just a brief overview of all the different ministries that you're engaged in?
We have a child development programs where we have right now three projects, two in slum areas and one in a village. And in that places, mostly they are the first generation children who are getting education. But we have seen education is not only the ultimate thing. Doing education, we need to give the basic food because they are malnourished. And going for education, we need to also make the children have a good social connection, because they come from a place where they use a lot of abusive language. They are abused, so that they have resentments. So we have a socio-emotional development, as well as our ultimate goal is to introduce Jesus with all our children. We came up with a residential program, so we have two homes which we call dream home for boys and dream home for girls, where we give a lot of children a safe place to stay and to study and to have much better life. We also have churches where we work in that areas where people have never heard about the name of Jesus. We also do a women empowerment program through the beautician course and tailoring course. And we have a church planting, as well as we have a community development. Through that, we give deep tubal, we give solar lights, we do a medical camps for a whole community.
Yeah, so in March, everything hit. So everything changed, and all of us across the world, we had to make adjustments in our plans and to change up what we were doing and how we were doing it. So how did COVID affect the ministries that you were involved in?
This whole 6 month time, it was really difficult. It is tough. So we started giving them food. We started giving them groceries. There were a lot of different difficulties that we faced, but we have also seen how God can work through this. We have seen how God's grace in Kalpa slum, where they are not much aware of all the do's and don'ts, but till today they have only prayed, and not a single one person is affected by COVID, where the COVID numbers are increasing day by day. Through tough time, we can experience God's grace more. If God is with us, who can stand against us? So we think that we can, I think overcome the obstacles.
That's so encouraging. Do you have a story that you can share of someone whose life has been changed or life has been affected by the ministries continuing during this crisis time?
One old lady named Pramila. And she was a maid servant working in someone's house. And during this COVID time, she was thrown out of the house like people. So she didn't have money. And for some time, she just went without food. She thought that I will die if I don't get food. And when she was thinking that, just the next day, we went for distributing groceries, and we gave food for 2 weeks. And she was so encouraged. She said, like, when I was thinking that my life will completely, I will experience death, but now I can survive just because of this grocery. So that was the only food throughout this last three or four months she received. Through that, she survived.
During this COVID time, we haven't do our church through Zoom as well as phone call and other things. And now when we have restarted our church, you can't imagine that more people have started attending to the church. During the COVID, we have done our church through phone call and Zoom, as well as 2-3 times we have distributed some food. So now many people have started attending to the church.
Yeah, so what I'm hearing you say is that when people are facing crisis, whether it's a hurricane or financial difficulties or sickness, you're seeing them turn to God and turn to the positive instead of to the negative. And so that's encouraging for us to hear. So if anyone watching this has been to India, one of our favorite parts is to go and visit the dream homes. And so can you share a story from the dream homes over the last 6 months? What has God been doing? What has God been up to in the lives of these kids?
So most of the children had initially very difficult time because the parents did not have jobs. They even did not have the toiletries. And when we started giving specially food and the toiletries to our children, they were really very, very happy. They said it is not only fed us, but the whole family. So they kept on asking us that when we will go back to dream home, when we will go back to dream home. Because that time, buses were not plying. Trains, even till now, it is not running, it is not plying. So they did not have any way to come back to the dream home. But through the bus which you have given, we brought all the children back to dream home. We had so many difficulties, but now we are in much safe place.
You know that along with the food packet, we have distributed meat and a chicken as well as fish, I think,
and
twice,
vegetables.
And vegetables twice. So that was the happiest part. When you see the smile of the face, yes, of the children, that actually really encouraging us. Thank you for providing money,
yes,
for distributing these food packets as well as food to the children. And we are really grateful to you for your support.
Well, it's our honor to be a part of it. And I just appreciate your resilience. And then you're just commitment to what God has called you to, even during times that none of us could have predicted. So my last question is that, you know, 2020 has been a crazy year. 2020 has been a year of challenge after challenge, but God is still moving and God is still working. So what are you dreaming about for the rest of the year and into 2021? What are you praying for? What are you hoping that God does?
So though there were a lot of obstacles, we are thanking God that we are able to do a spiritual retreat this month. We are also hoping that we will be able to at least do something during the time of Christmas.
From the spiritual side, many people actually waiting to take water baptism. You know, every year during the retreat, we do have baptism program, but this year purposely we are not having. We want to celebrate God's faithfulness in our life with you all. And till then, I'm hoping that will be the highest number of people waiting to take water baptism. We know that obstacle and difficulties is part of our life. But our prayer would be, God, give us strength to overcome these difficulties.
So if someone who is watching this wants to be involved, how can they find you? How can they get involved with the work?
They can get involved with the website. There is a website of Seed India, and they can also contact Seed India for any further support and all the information and all the work that we do.
Yeah, so that's seedindia.us, also on Instagram, Facebook, all the social media websites. So I am grateful for you, Pias, and grateful for you, Jayshree. Grateful for the work that you do, and just want you to know that we're with you through all the difficulties, and we are here for you.
We are so very thankful to God for giving us a partner like you all, who are not only donors, who are not only partners, but who are our well-wishers, our family members, our friends. So thank you for your love, concern, support, and everything.